another flag.
One, two, three, four.
Ice cream sandwich,
and I've got
a hot dog thing.
Like a apple crumble thing.
Have you bought lots so far?
Yeah.
Are we going to do a haul?
We're going to do a haul. The next thing is going
to be a haul. Yeah, we're going to do a haul. So yeah, we're going to eat this and then we'll go, could do some more shops.
Yeah, do some more shops and then go watch the evening.
Yeah.
Let's get eating. So we've just finished walking around the shops. We've got a couple more things that we'll show you in the next video, the shopping mall. And we just stopped, got drinks.
We've got really sore feet.
Drinks, and sit down.
It's very hot in here.
Yes. So I'll see you in the arena when it's time to go in. So we made it to the arena. It looks bigger on... We made it to the arena. It looks bigger on TV. The jumps look bigger on TV, but they're still really big.
This is the jockeys jumping, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's the first thing. Jockeys, I think it's like a charity class. And then there's dog agility, and then there's some devil's horsemen, and then there's some cavalry thing. And then, which I'm not that bothered about, so we might go and get tea at that point. And then
I'm bothered about that.
Are you?
Ah, I want to watch all of it.
And then there's the Grand Prix show jumping, which is massive.
Is it like that big?
It's 165 normally, I think.
It's about that big.
Bigger than you.
My lords, ladies and gentlemen, 5 more sleeps until Christmas Day. It's an honour and a privilege to welcome you all to the final performance of the London International Horse Show 2022.
Party.
Andrews will lead them out of the first. She's the team captain, leading female jumps jockey, and had her first festival winner in 2018. Also joining her is the fantastic Rachel Blackmore, of course, rider over 400 winners, first female jockey who won the Grand National, of course. In there too, Hayley Turner, flat jockey, one of the very best we've seen, and reaches the 1,000 winner landmark. So close to that right now, and that will be coming very, very soon. And Safi Osborne, daughter of the famous jockey, turned trainer Jamie, represented at the Pony Europeans at Eventing back in 2018, now riding as an apprentice jockey and ridden almost 100 winners in just 3 years. And joining them, Joanna Mason. Rode as an amateur for many seasons before turning pro on the flat in 2020. Rode her 100th winner in June this year. We've got national winners. We've got all of the lineup in here. The ladies are looking strong. Pippa's right. Where are you for the ladies out there? But look at the boys. Led in by the 20-time champion jump jockey, the most winning, most jockey ever. 4,358 winners. Welcome the great Sir Anthony A.P. McCoy. And then, just behind him, son of Nick, brother of Dan. Over the last 4 weekends, 4 Grade 1 wins. Son of the Olympic gold medalist, showjumper Nick. And the champion jockey 2021. And he's won over 1,000 winners. That's a great for the charity here. So, it's Bridget, good luck here. Bridget, who's been leading at female jockey, had a first Cheltenham winner in 2018, as we mentioned. Been out with injury this year, but she's back in the saddle. And of course, married to Harry Skelton as well for her sins too. But going nicely so far, Gombridge, good start. Right. Quick turn back here, nothing to add at the moment. The best 4 scores from a team of 5 are added together to see who will be the winning team. I think we've got all the rules out of the way now. Turning back to Santa, that's the last one on course, so the clock will stop at 32:20. She can take 4 off if she leaves this up. Yes, she does! So, 28.
It is the 20 time the best the world has ever seen. You know who it is? It's the greatest, AP! Here we go. Remember Bridget's time, 28.20. Off they go. Rides out every single morning. Good turn inside. Ooh. Right, 25, 26, he's quicker. AP breaks the beam at 29.81, don't have it down. It's 25.81
for Greg. For sponsoring tonight, so we're underway with the second of the lady riders. They're a little bit back because AP had a very good time. Remember, it's cumulative score, but that could make a difference. Joanna here, terrific run that she's had since she's moved on to professional ranks in 2020, rode 100th winner. She had a great start in point to pointing as well, so she can handle it over the jumps. Lights out. Back we come. So that's 3 seconds to add to the time, but if she jumps the last, she can take 4 seconds off. Joanna gets very tight round there. This is looking good so far. Remember, AP McCoy was stealing championship horses. She's coming down the last and looking good. Let's take off. Oh, 4. It's going to add 4, but never mind.
1,500 winners today. It is the incomparable Brian Hughes, and he's off and racing. Steady, Brian. Steady. Look at that turn. Oh, I say. Off we go. Over the candles. Over the London fence. Good turn inside. Over the stained glass. Now back and over. Yep, it was going to happen. Coming to 2 from home. 3 seconds to add. Oh, rodeo, baby. Now we come down. 30.94, 30.94, 30. 27.94, I think.
One of the top lady flat jockeys. Good turn up here. You can cheer louder than that. Let's get us some encouragement going around here. Let's pick up the speed. over the London fence. Good turn back so far. She's keeping efficient. Look at that for a good turn inside. Does she pull it off? Not quite. So 3 seconds to add for that one, but she's going to get going now, get scrubbing and get running over the final few fences. Looking good. Inside turn for the last. Come on, Hayley, let's get home as fast as we can. The ladies are going to just break there at 33.50. Leave it up, leave it up, leave it up. Love! Career in the Shetland Pony Grand National is the former champion jump. Flat jockey, it is the mighty rider of Bailly, Jim Crowley, and he's a superstar. He rode across the fences and on the flat. Come on, Crowley. Over that, now look at this turn. He doesn't take a turn. Whoa! It's still up. He's on a 14-2 pony, and we are motoring, aren't we? Look at the time. Come on, Crowley. Hands on heels. Over the line. 28-29. Come on, Jim. Come on, Jim. Come on, Jim. 24-29. But almost 100 winners now in just 3 years, one of the rising stars of the weighing room. Time to show us what you've got here, Savvy. We need a bit of ground making up on the boys, and the good thing is they're going to cheer for you even louder this time. Let's get going. Get running. Get us good turn inside. Little bend and a weave. And they're over, looking good. She's going to try and keep up with Jim Crowley's real flyer there that really, well, gets a little bit wide. Sun gets going. One more fence. This looks a good one. This is a good one to make it up for the girls. And leave the last, pray. Carnival time in Dubai at the moment. Takes the turn in, up and over. Remember, look at Jim Crowley's time, 24.29. Can anybody touch that? I know that Skelton will be coming up later, but you're having a good one. Over the stained glass, now the lanterns, it stays. Little pony turn there. Oh, look at the hands and heels as we head towards the Elizabeth line. We're still clear. Where are you going? Back we come, up and over. Look at the clock, 30.88. Over the last, it's 26.88. The boys, they get their hands back on the trophy. Out there on the start line, Rob Hunter, the senior starter of the Kennel Club, is ready to go. He says, system's ready, and it's all guns blazing because we want you to cheer tonight. The louder you cheer, the faster they run. Here goes Edge, off over the first two. Tricky line that, very tricky line, because they'll want to go straight to it. It requires very good, accurate handling. Look at that turn, silky smooth, over the dog walk, the first of the contacts. Down the other side, they swing left-handed. Now they go into the tunnel for the first time. Out of that dingy dark tunnel and over the wall into the tunnel. Over the Skinner's vertical. Now back over the Kennel Club. A-frame, 1, 2, 3, 4. Hits the contact, long jump, now the weave. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And we come in 30 exactly. And now this is the last line and it's clear. 34-5-1-1, Joe Gleed, and Edge going to the lead. Super excited this afternoon. Nicola sets the seesaw down. Remember that, has to hit the deck. Good handling there, very good handling. Now over the dog walk, down the other side, back over the snowman. Now into the tunnel for the first time, over the wall. Back over, still in touch and still clear. Now up over the A-frame. And this is very much in touch. This is very much in touch. If we're going to go wee. Out. Out. And now cheer London, cheer London, cheer. And it's a good run. Not talking enough. Here's the second. That keeps on giving. Over the snowman. Down the seesaw. Had a good run. Gets the contact through the tyre. Look at the, it's the sport of finest of margins, this dog agility. And it's all about interaction with man's best friend, and they're interacting quite brilliantly. Now, up and over, over the Skinner's vertical, and it's 22 seconds on the clock, and it's game on, 35, 34, 5, 11 is the time to beat. We're coming home, it can do it, it can do it, it can do it! 33. 6-3. Yes, you can now. Off we go. I'm here, everybody. Down goes the seesaw. Gets the contact. It's on the way down. That's a bit of a wide run there, but a very good turn back. Up and over. And they are really flying. They really are. Look at this. Look at the ears pricked. The tail's going. Everything's going. We are motoring. Blink from you, my business. 24 at the A-frame. It's in touch. 33-6-3-8 in the way. This is the quickest we've seen so far. Come on, let's go. Shoot out, 35-2-3. In the Pony Grand National. Number five, Lucas Murphy. His dad, Timmy Murphy, went up against the likes of A.P. McCoy on many times, went on with compliance. He's been behind the Shetland Pony Grand National this year, raising so much money, getting them under starters orders, is former jockey and now trainer Joe Akehurst. And they get a fast start. Number five gets a good run on there and gets the speed going. That's Lucas Murphy. Murphy's ASC double. Coming in on the inside is number two. That's Toby Moore. It's the battle of the next generation. So far, Ryan Moore's son just coming up on the inside. Nose to nose between these two at the moment. Between Murphy and Moore once again. Where have we heard that before? Number two, Toby Moore gets the advantage at this point. And just tracking them is the grey. That's number nine. That's Finn Murphy and Phil Lord Edwards, so brother getting involved now as well. But just a half a length ahead now is number two, Toby Moore, running home with greatness energy. Close up then is going to be Lucas Murphy. The rest of the pack is starting to trail. Creeping up is number six, that's Bethy Naylor Davis and Sherwick Bentley. Can they get the top three? They're going for the line. It's looking like it's going to be Toby Moore to get across the line first. Number five just after that, and maybe just squeaking in number six. So number two at the top, Toby Moore brings it home. The Moore name once again in the winner's circle. All sets, and first of all, we're handing to our lineup there. They're going to be handing over a check in just a moment too for the presentation. Vault champion going to join them as well. The biggest cheer of the season. Ladies and gentlemen, the winning combination of the last Shetland Pony Grand National of 2022. Of course, the Shetland Fold Blossom, very, very Merry Christmas. Getting some elves down there.
You definitely shouldn't drive home, because the Napru family have been setting a standard in modern film work, and today they are here to show you why they are the best stunt team in the world. Lords, ladies and gentlemen, will you rock the building for the Devil's Horsemen? not done yet, but they've taken more risks tonight than on any other performance. Give them a cheer, the Devil Conquer!
Amazing on it to start with.
So basically all of it?
Yeah. And then show jumping starting in a minute.
Yeah. So we'll see you back in the arena.
I do. Yeah.
makes the time. No, no, it doesn't. 60. Definitely one for the future, that it really is. For Sweden, with H&M Christian K, the Stockholm Grand Prix winner, Petter Fredriksson. Has he done it?
Oh, yes.
Oh, Lorenzo. Thank you. To go in the Turkish Airlines London Grand Prix, time to beat 31.88. Dennis Lynch, good luck.
So, London International was so fun. We got loads of stuff that we bought. And it was just so fun. We saw show jumping. We left before the prize giving because I was very tired and I wanted to go back. Well, I didn't, but Mummy said that we had to queue for our shopping because we did the shop and drop. So where you shop, basically, is like what it sounds, shop. And then was it, where do we have to drop it off?
Pony Club. It was £3 for the whole day and night, and you could collect stuff after anything finished, which was good. And we didn't have to queue, did we?
No.
So it's now the next morning, isn't it?
Yes, it's the next morning.
So the first thing we saw was the jockey for the injured jockeys fund. So they did the jockeys
team
show
jumping. Yeah, so girls versus boys, but it didn't really matter who won because they're both doing it for the same charity.
Yeah, and Pippa Funnel was the trainer of the girls.
And
Nick Skelton was the trainer of the boys.
I was asking Nick, but I didn't know his surname. So I was like,
and it was actually, I wasn't really that sort of bothered about that, but I thought that was brilliant. I really got into that. They were so fast, weren't they?
One of them one of the boys on like a chestnut, down the aisle, he was just cantering in.
Yeah, he like proper almost galloped in, didn't he? He knew from the start that he was going to be going. The guy on the little black pony as well. 14.2 black pony was the fastest, I think.
It was a pony.
Yeah.
It's actually a pony.
It's so cute.
What? Okay, yeah.
And then what else did you see?
We saw the dog agility and the Shetland Pony Grand Nationals. And I'm just going to speak and then I'll go back to the dog agility because they were so cute.
That was amazing, wasn't it? They were so fast.
They were so cute.
I know. So good. And then
The Shetland Pony Grand National
was cool, and
show jumping.
There was the Devil's Horse men as well. They were insane, weren't they?
Yeah.
Absolutely insane.
I liked when they stood up on like two horses and they did the race.
This is just bonkers. I love it the way they go down the bottom and then one by one they all bomb up and do it.
And then the last two on their sides go down, and then the last time they did it, the man that was on the left side from where we were sitting did like a handstand but stood in the saddle. And then the other one, I think, would he like hang out from the stirrup and did that.
This is insane, isn't it?
Do not try that at home.
No, do not try that at home. And then there was the cavalry thing. I don't know how you say it because it's French. They did that kind of drill ride thing, didn't they?
Yeah.
And then ended with...
And one horse was stood in the middle the whole time and it was the boss.
Yeah, the boss.
The boss.
And then it ended with the show jumping, didn't it? The Grand Prix.
And then it would have ended with the prize giving, but Mummy didn't.
Well, we had to walk back to where we were staying, so... But
it
all in
like
all...
It took 5 minutes. Probably less than that.
All in all, it was a good day, wasn't it?
Yeah.
We got lots of shopping, which we're going to show you in another video. So, should we wrap up this one?
Yep. So, thank you for watching. I'll see you all in the next video. Bye!